So today we're going to look at these EV charger test adapters and why they're a fantastic bit of kit if you're installing EV charge points.
I'll start off with a fantastic bit of kit. This is probably the cheapest EV car on the market. Well, it's mimicking one, so we can plug it in and carry out some of those tests that are needed, a current to flow, in other words, those live aspects of testing.
Yeah, if you don't have one of those, yeah, there's so many safety features built into an EV charge point that if you don't have one of those to create the impression that there's a car there, it'd be impossible to do those tests unless you say wanted to remove the cover. But obviously you've installed the charger and you want to validate that it's actually working, so you don't have a return visit to site if it actually doesn't work.
And the A1532, we've done it on the channel already. Me and Joe have gone all the way through how to carry out the tests on an EV charging point. And if you haven't seen that video, we'll leave it in the link in the description and possibly the eye above our heads.
Yes, it will be. That is a fantastic video, yeah. But today we're not looking at the test procedure itself. We're going to take a closer look at the testers themselves, or the test adapters, and some of the clever features that are in an EV charge point that will explain how these work and what obviously these various buttons do. So I think first, Gary, let's probably have a look at the common Type 2 plug
that
most EVs now use when they're charging at home. So I've got one here. If I take the cover off.
Okay, let's have a little look in there.
So we'll see, obviously, familiar connections. Earth connection. Obviously, three phases, because these can support up to three-phase charging, neutral. And then these two here labelled PP and CP, which are the key to the operation of our test adapter and obviously the charge point itself.
Can you just remind what PP stands for?
So PP is the proximity pilot, or it's also known as plug present. So I think the car is plugged in and ready to charge. And then the CP, the control pilot, then talks between the charger and the car itself.
Right.
And obviously they have a conversation, say the car wants 32 amps, the charger says, actually, I'm capable of producing 32 amps. And just so you can see what's going on there, we've managed to pull out a circuit diagram, very simplified version of what's actually going on between the car and the charger.
Right, okay, so as I look at that, there was something we investigated, wasn't it? That the lead itself is probably the key element of this. So I might have 32 amp fuse, I might have the ability to draw 32 amps into the car, but my lead might not be rated at that, would it?
Yeah, and that was something surprising we found out, and that's where the proximity pilot comes in, or the plug present. There's a resistor between the PP connection and the earth, or the protective earth in the cable, that the value of that resistor tells the charger and the car what capacity the cable connecting the two together has.
Okay, so that makes perfect sense. I get a lead that's only capable of doing 13 amps. I sit in the car, or it takes forever to charge up, and I'm ringing up the electrician saying, well, hang on a minute, you've put a 32 amp supply in it. I know my car can take it. It's taking three times as long to charge as you said it would. Well, actually, the first fault finding thing is have a look at that lead, isn't it?
Yeah, you've bought an incredibly competitively priced lead on a well-known online retailer that does next day free delivery. And perhaps it's not to the specification of the original cable that came with the car. And obviously, as time goes on, cables are going to wear out. You might need a replacement. So that was something, we thought was quite interesting to note as we've gone through this, that, if you've ever had a service call and the car's not charging at the rate, it could be down to the cable.
Yeah, that's a really key piece of information. Also, as we look at these two adapters, it looks as if I've got a different button arrangement on the new one. Do you want to take a little closer look at that?
Yes, so there is. So let's have a closer look at the tester. So this is the 1532XA from Metrel.
Okay.
And so here's our button that mimics the PP, or the proximity pilot, or the plug present, so you can set that to different current ratings.
And that's the rated value of the fuse supplying the EV charger, isn't it?
Yeah, that's capable of supplying. And then we've got the control pilot that mimics the effect that the car is plugged in basically a standby mode, or say the car's fully charged, or in position C that the car is charging. Now, if we compare and contrast this with the previous version that we featured in our earlier video, we had this button E.
Right, okay.
So button E was for an error code. And that was basically the control pilot connection had been lost or wasn't there to mimic that, and at which point the charger should shut down.
Okay, yep, so that was just one fault. You pressed the button in the video that you can see in the link in the description. It created a fault, and obviously it stopped charging, didn't it?
Yeah, and yeah, that was fine, but obviously EV chargers always changing in different parts of the world have brought different chargers standards in and different fault tests that they want electricians to do. So Metrel have kept up to date with that, and that E button has now been replaced by three individual buttons.
Okay, so I'll bring it in. I'll have a little look at the three new buttons. So they're the three there. So
yeah. So the most obviously probably popular one would be this one here. So this is a simulates that the fault in the earth connection to the car.
So between the charger and the car, there's a fault with the earth. That's a fault now that we can test for.
We can test for that. Here's a problem with our control pilot.
So that's similar to what we had before, yeah?
That's similar to what we had before. And then there's this other button here with the diode symbol that's simulating a fault within the electronics of the actual charger in the car.
Oh, right.
And so, yeah, so you've got those three options. So it may not be a requirement in this country, as we say on EV charging, yet.
Yeah, okay. So in other parts of the world it is. So Metrel have obviously updated theirs in order to add those functions in. That's really good. I like that. Where do you want to take me next?
So we'll just to prove that fact on the plug present connection.
You're going to measure the resistance for me?
We can just measure the resistance. So okay. let's boot up our Metrel. We've got the 3155 today. We've gone for the Rolls Royce version here, so I'll just do a single test. Let's have a look for low continuity test.
Right, so we think there's different values now, don't we, depending on the amp rating of the lead?
Yeah, so this is a 32 amp cable, so we expect this to be around 220 ohms. So I'm going to probe between, I'll just take the top off that one there so we can get into the earth connection between there and our proximity pilot.
So measuring that resistance, and you expect it to be?
Press the play button, Gary, remember that?
Wow, go. Spot on.
Yeah.
So that resisted value tells the car and charger, the communications, that actually we've got a rated 32 amps, is that right?
32 amp cable.
So what about if it was a different value? What about so if the lead was different?
If it's a lower value, then that value tends to increase.
Oh, right, okay.
So it's
that's clever.
It is clever, and until we made this video, we didn't realise. Just turn that button to that. We've tested them before, but we don't actually know what's going on with that button. And Metrel have added another function, okay. Because what do we sometimes add now at the origin of our supply?
Origin of our supply, we add current transformers. I'm going for.
Yes.
I was going to go somewhere else then. I've gone current transformer. Yeah.
Where were you off to?
Well, no, I'll leave it. So current transformer. So what we could have a situation is that we've installed an EV charger. Like we did the Zappy.
Yep.
You haven't checked out our EV install where we took that journey through. Again, there'll be a link in the description. So that had a current transformer that measured so we didn't overstress the incoming fuse.
Yep.
Also linked to the app, didn't it?
Yeah.
But what if I've got the charger installed before the car as the electrician, and I want to confirm that, because it wasn't that wirelessly connected?
Yeah, that was wirelessly connected. There's hardwired current transformers. Yeah. But what the easiest mistake to make on a current transformer is what's that, Gary?
It could be the wrong way round.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the power flow is going, completely opposite direction. Yeah, again, it's a very simple mistake to make, especially when you've got multiple tails and the meter box is a bit of a jumble. You can put them around the wrong way. So one way to test for that is to use the test adapter. So say you've commissioned the app on behalf of the customer.
Right, okay.
That's going to show you the power flow. You can still connect your meter through the terminals.
So use the banana plugs, yeah?
Yeah, the banana plugs.
Okay, cool. Use those, yeah.
But then you can plug something like, a fan heater.
Like a fan heater?
Yeah, so you plug the fan heater in to mimic the fact that there's a car there. So you'd set it to state C, car's right. Charging, plug in a 1 kilowatt heater or a load.
And then my app will tell me.
And then hopefully if your app set up and the current transformer's in the right direction, you can do that test.
So the car's not there, we've not arrived, we've got any of those issues, and that means we're leaving it, and we're probably not going to have that call back, are we?
Yeah, so we're confident we've done the installation.
That is a nice little feature, and one that we found out as well today, didn't we, that you can do.
So again, Metrel, keeping up to date with the changes in the market. Obviously, when we've used this, we're pairing it with that. We've used the 3152. We've stepped up to the 3155 here. And obviously, that if you haven't seen the video on that, the meter itself guides you through the whole test procedure.
It does.
But you can also make changes yourself. Because another thing we've noticed a lot is happening with EV chargers is a lot of them have all of the RCD functions built into the charger itself,
yep.
But some of the ones we're seeing now just have the DC leakage part in there and then rely upon an external RCD as well. So you may want to come up with a dedicated function or test sequence for the charger that you're actually installing.
Okay, and we've done that before. We did that in a different, we reconfigured some for three-phase insulation resistance, didn't we?
We had the 10 tests
for the insulation resistance. We configured it in there. Again, check out that video because we could program it in so it automatically did it through the switch, didn't it?
That's it.
As always, we're interested in your feedback on anything to do with EV. We've done a massive series of videos, and if you haven't checked them all out, there is a playlist on EV, and it'd be worth working your way through it. If you're new to EV, or you're looking to buy an EV, but there is one thing we want to address that keeps coming up. We know this over here is not charging the vehicle. What is it actually doing,
yes,
Gordon?
It's a connection point to enable you to charge the vehicle, the actual charge, and people correct us on that all of the time. And
they do.
Entirely right that actually this charge point here, it isn't an EV charger, it's a connection. It powers AC into the car, where the charger and electronics in the car actually transform that AC into the DC required to charge the battery in this case. But perhaps in the future we'll look at some of the generation of fast DC chargers that are coming along that use a slightly different approach.
And if there's anything else you want us to touch on in this series, but first of all, check the playlist, see what we have done in there. If there's anything missing you'd like us to add in it, leave it in the comments below. We'll try and add it in, and we'll get back to as many of those comments as we can.